It's Friday, and all the anguish and agony of the past week has surrendered to the glorious resurrection. This is the crux of our Christian faith. This is why we have a reason to rejoice. This is why salvation is real. He is risen, and life is glorious. But the journey to the resurrection was not an easy one. From the moment Jesus came to us as a child in a manger, he became acquainted with our grief, with our temptation, with love and loss. As he grew, I suppose he felt all the things that mankind feels. And that's why he came to us, to know us. Those who knew him best were surely witnesses to the struggles of a man who was God and a God who was man. I can only imagine that as his friends stood by observing the miracles and listening to the conversations of love that poured out of him, their hearts must have burned with joy and honor to even stand beside him. And for those who met him only briefly, they still understood the power and magnitude of this man called Jesus.
Thank you.
but they thought it was just dinner with a friend. As they broke bread, their hearts also broke at the revelations Jesus shared with them, at the mere suggestion that one of them would betray him, and at the sheer love that he poured out onto them like wine. "Eat of this bread," he told them, "and remember me." "Drink," he said, "and think of me. I have chosen you."
None of us in this room were in the upper room with Jesus and his disciples.
Nor were we there in the Garden of Gethsemane when he made the final decision that the Father's will would be done, regardless of the price. But every one of us can wear the crown of redemption purchased by those moments of decision when God, out of his great love for man, chose the long, long road to Calvary.
Give up
He's alive. Yes, he was dead. Yes, he was buried. But now he's alive forevermore. Let the church tell it over and over, so all the world hears the wonderful news that Jesus has broken every chain of death, hell, and the grave. And we are free.